and turn to Ezekiel chapter 27. We're going to be looking in some scriptures there as well, Ezekiel 27, and then of course John chapter 12. Those are two scriptures that we're going to be looking at to start off tonight. So you might be wondering, what in the world is going on today? We have a big push, and it has been over the last few years, for socialized medicine. And of course the administration we have now has done some things that is really, you know, to a Christian, it's been, if you read the Bible and you're a Christian, then it doesn't exactly line up with what we believe as Christians, nor does it line up with what the intent and purposes of God is. However, we do believe that all things work for good to them who are called according to His purposes. We found out in James that even though we're going through trials of affliction, trials of situations that happen, everything is happening to mature us. All things work for our good, for those who love the Lord. So one of the reasons I wanted to really stir you this morning is to get you to come back to the point that you need to repent and go back to your first love, the Lord Jesus. The Bible says if we love Him, if we meditate upon His Word, then nothing shall offend us. Amen. Falling in love with Jesus. If we don't love Him, then guess what? God has a serious charge against us. He can move candlestick right out of our church. We can do a lot of church activities. We can do a lot of religious works. And we can be so active religiously and miss the Lord. 2,000 years ago, there was a group of people so active. They were called Jews. They made sure all the pots and pans were washed in the tabernacle. They made sure the tabernacle was kept up. But you know what? When the Lord came, they missed the Lord.
Amen.
I don't want any of you missing the Lord. I want all of you to get a full reward. I want you, when you see the Lord Jesus, to say, wow, praise God. And I want Him to say to you, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter to the joy of the Lord. There's going to be some sweet words. Amen?
Amen.
So I don't want you to miss out on anything God has got for you as His children. That's why I preach so passionately and so fervently, because I believe the calling of God is the highest calling that a man can receive on planet Earth. Amen.
Amen.
And for you to be able to serve is such a wonderful privilege. Amen. Enjoy God's work. Enjoy the church. Don't let it be a stress or burden to you. Enjoy the Lord. And when He calls you to serve Him, enjoy the Lord. Do it joyfully. When you give, do it joyfully. When you work, do it joyfully. Don't come under no pressure of any sort, because God's got everything in His hand. Praise God.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not unto your own understanding, and He will direct your paths. Amen. And He also will give you the desires of your heart. If you want to serve Him, He'll open doors for you.
Praise God.
Amen. If you want to serve Him, He'll open those sweet doors.
Amen.
If you look around, there's plenty a Christian can do. Amen. There are so many things, so many ways we can go. And if you read through the Bible, there's no place for retirement in the Bible. As long as you're alive and breathing the good air that God gives you, as long as you're in the right mind, you may can't do nothing but wall your eyes around your eye sockets. You may be bedridden, but you know what? You can have a little gleam in your eye because the Holy Ghost is right there stirring you up. You may lose your voice, may lose your body. You may lose everything, and your mind may be working a little bit. But you know what? You can still serve the Lord by having that hope within your eyes.
Amen.
I went and visited a preacher years ago, right after the 9/11 scenario in 2011. I told him, and he was in the nursing home. He had preached all his life, and I shared with him, and he rose up a little bit and said, the judgment of the Lord. So if you have the God's Word shut up in your heart, there's no place for retirement. Amen. I want to tell you that. So stay active in the Word of God. Stay active in your mind. Don't think that you're used and dilapidated and out of sorts and rusted away and too old to do anything for the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. So here we are. In John chapter 12 and Ezekiel, if you have your Bibles, chapter 27, we'll start in Ezekiel chapter 27. We are in this situation where we're $1 trillion in debt. Our current leaders are taking advantage because of our financial collapses, and they are creating